Hello. Today I'm going to quickly show you how to use the CPDLC. CPDLC is present in some planes. I personally use XPlane 12 with Tolis A320. However, this approach is pretty standard and it should be valid for most simulators and most planes. The first thing you need to do in order to be able to use the CPDLC is to register on the Hoppie ACARS site. Hoppie is a network that is used by a simulator to imitate the CPDLC, and to register you need to go to the site, and the link to that is present in the description under this video. Click on the get login code, type your full name, your email address, enter the anti-abuse riddle, and click register. You will shortly receive via the email your custom login code, and then by going into my account page and typing the full name and email address you provided during the registration and the login code that you received via the email, you can configure your account. By default, the account is configured with the VATSIM network. However, you can choose any other network that you use, or if you are not playing online, then choose no, update the network, and we are free to go. The second thing that we need to do is to configure our plane. In Tolis, we do that in the Tolis panel in the Sounds add-on accounts. And here you should type or paste your Hoppie CPDLC login. We can recheck if it's working. It works. So now I can save that. And we are ready to use the CPDLC in our plane. To do that, I will power on plane and we can start doing that. Everything basically that is related to the CPDLC is present in the ATC communication submenu. Here we can go to the connection and the notification. And as you can see, the notification center is not set. However, we see the information that the notification is unavailable. It's because we need to initiate our FMS before working with the CPDLC. So to do that, I will insert the from to. That's the first thing that is required. Echo Papa Whiskey Alpha to Echo Papa Golf Delta. I'm using Polish airports. However, this station that I will show you in the network will work globally. And we need to enter the flight route. Let's use Whiskey Zulu Zulu 255. And that's everything that you need to set up in order to use the CPDLC. Now let's go to this like connection page one more time, notification, and now we can choose the ATC center. On VATSIM, you will be provided with the valid network and valid station. However, if you are using the non-network, I suggest to use the Echo Papa WW, which is the ATC station created by me. It's automatic and it's all work globally. So we are typing it here. We are clicking notify. And as you can see, the Echo Papa Whiskey Whiskey has been notified at this time. Now we are waiting for the ATC station to reply to our message. That's something that can take from, let's say, 20 seconds to 1 minute. A CPDLC network is not a, like instant communication, so it's not like Slack or Discord when you send a message and 1 second later you get a response. That's something that takes and not the mission critical communication. As you can see, we received the confirmation from the ATC, and current ATC active, it's Echo Papa Whiskey Whiskey. We can check the connection status and we see as well here that the connection is active. So what can we do right now? So you can use this CPDLC to communicate with the ATC, and there are many different ways of this communication. So lateral request, vertical request, and other requests. Lateral request is, for example, when you want to ask if we can go direct to or go to use some particular heading, etc. So let's try this direct to. So we can say that we want to go direct to Gruda. I'm typing it here, and here I can send the or create the message, and then the message is created here. We can see it's request direct to Gruda. I can send it here. It's sent to the ATC station. And now we need to wait for the ADC station to respond. As I told you earlier, this can take up to 1 minute, so I'll use this time to explain other elements. So in the vertical request, we can choose, for example, climb or descent to, and we can type, for example, that we want to climb to flight level 3 to 0, or we can say that we want to climb to flight level 3 to 0, but starting at point, for example, Subix. So I can type that as well here, and then I can send it to the ATC. I can add some additional text, so I can say that I want to climb to flight level 3 to 0 at Subix due to aircraft performance, and I will get back to that in a few seconds. As you can see, we've received a response from the ADC station, and they are saying that in reply to our request, send at this time, we can proceed directly to Gruda. I can say, Wilco, send the confirmation, and now it's sent. Let's close that, and let's get back to that. So I can add this text to the communication, and now I can send the request. And this request look like this. Request climb to flight level 3 to 0 at Subix due to aircraft performance. Let's send it, and let's wait also a couple of seconds until the ADC will respond. What else we can do? We can use this one to obtain the clearance. So after putting the whole track to the FMS, so I can choose here, for example, that I want departure from the runway 33 using Avina. Yeah, here, at Subix climb to maintain. So standby. Standby I can use if I want to like wait some time and check if I'm able to do that. And if I'm able to do that, it's showing I'm standing by. The ATC received the information that I need some time, and now I can confirm that, send the confirmation, and it's done. Getting back to that, we have the Avina. Let's choose an arrival, and let's choose the ILS 29. With the Elon for Tango department, departure, sorry, and here we can type that we want to go through the Gruda. And yes, and let's remove the discontinuity, insert, and right now, as the full track is here, we can also use the ADC to obtain a clearance. This clearance will look like this. Request from Echo Papa Whiskey Alpha to Echo Papa Golf Delta to these elements, send it. And now we need to wait for the clearance from the ATC. Of course, this auto-replying ATC station, Echo Papa Whiskey, is not integrated with the X-Plane, so it's not that it's integrated with the ADC communication that we can see here. However, it's good enough to play and learn how the CPDLC can work. Cleared to Echo Papa Golf Delta via Vina Gruda Irlon Squawk 3-2-6-5-4. Wilco, send, and it's done. So that's how it works. If you have any questions related to the operations of CPDLC, please feel free to leave me a comment, and have a nice time playing with the ACARS. Thank you very much.